even though he was crucified. If you were to go back and reconstruct the story of Jesus, not using scripture or not using church fathers, not using anyone who's a Christian, just using the most ancient records we have. Now, I'm going to include some details here from a couple of accounts I couldn't get to in 28 minutes that are on the website. This is what you would know about Jesus from the absolute bare minimum. From this is just the non-Christian accounts. You're going to get a lot of information about Jesus from non-Christians early. Here's what it says. Jesus, we would know from just the non-Christians in early history, was a real man who lived in history. He was reportedly born of a virgin. He had an earthly father who was a carpenter. He lived in Judea, in the region known as Palestine. He was wise. He was righteous. His teaching was so influential that he developed a large following of Jewish and Gentile followers. He taught his disciples to live with the same virtue that he exhibited, and his moral code was exceedingly high, but he was more than just a moral teacher. He possessed magical powers and had the ability to accurately predict the future. His supernatural acts and teachings persuaded many Jews to walk away from their Jewish beliefs. Jesus claimed to be God, and his disciples readily accepted that claim. The Jewish leadership ultimately brought charges against Jesus based on his actions and his teaching, and Pontius Pilate, during the reign of Tiberius Caesar, crucified and prosecuted him. There was an earthquake and darkness at the point of the execution, and his followers, Jesus' followers, reported seeing him resurrected after the crucifixion, 3 days afterwards. And however, Jesus, and even Jesus showed them his wounds. Now, not only that, his believers believed that the resurrection was a proof that Jesus was in fact the Messiah, and they adopted his moral teaching. They lived their lives accordingly. They held their belief in his deity. They held firm to that, even though it meant they were going to suffer under the Roman rule. As a matter of fact, they were persecuted for their faith in Christ. All of that information, all of that history of Jesus and his followers, you would know if you never opened your Bible. You can get that from non-Christian sources in the first and early second century. That's pretty powerful. A lot more to be said about this, and I'm afraid we're running out of time. But you can find out more at the website, Cold Case Christianity. Just scroll down. There are articles. Use the search engine there for evidence for Jesus outside the scriptures. I've also written quite a bit about this in the book, Cold Case Christianity. Wow. We covered a lot of information today, and I hope it was helpful to you. See you here next week at Cold Case Christianity.
Thanks for joining us at the Cold Case Christianity broadcast. If you're interested in more information about this week's topic, please visit coldcasechristianity.com. For a thorough investigation of the reliability of the New Testament Gospels and the case for Christianity, be sure to purchase Cold Case Christianity, A Homicide Detective Investigates the Claims of the Gospels. It's available wherever books are sold.